Welcome. This is Mr. W, and this is Basic Chemistry for Biology students. The subject of this video, covalent bonds and structural formulas. Let's start with a bit of review. Our last video focused on ionic bonding. We started with the idea that, in accordance with the Octet Rule, atoms are only happy if their outer orbitals are full to capacity, with 2 electrons in the first orbital, 8 in the second, and 8 in the third. Ionic bonding happens when unhappy atoms team up with one another and exchange electrons in a way that fills their outer orbitals. As they do this, these unhappy atoms become charged ions that stick together. And that attraction between oppositely charged ions is an ionic bond. Ions and ionic bonding are crucial in biology. But the molecules that make up living things, like DNA, which stores and transmits genetic information, are held together primarily by a second type of bond, the covalent bond. We'll start by looking at the structure of hydrogen gas, or H2. H2, hydrogen, is the simplest and most common molecule in the universe. How does it form? Well, it's all about atomic happiness. A hydrogen atom has one proton and one electron. As a single atom, hydrogen is unhappy. Why? Because the first energy level has a capacity of 2 electrons, and hydrogen with 1 electron only has 1 electron in that first orbital. With 1 electron, hydrogen is simply unfulfilled. By sharing its electrons with another hydrogen atom, hydrogen can achieve an atomic version of happiness. Here's what it looks like when 2 hydrogen atoms share their 2 electrons. This sharing holds the 2 atoms together, and that is exactly what a covalent bond is. It's when atoms are bound together by one or more pairs of shared electrons. Let's look at a slightly more complex molecule. The molecule is methane, also known as natural gas. Its formula is CH4. Notice that there's no number next to that C. That indicates that there's one carbon bonded to 4 hydrogen atoms. All around our planet, methane is a very important fuel source, and it's also very significantly involved in climate change, a topic that I've addressed in a series of music videos. Here's methane burning on my kitchen stove. Methane's formula, as we just said, is CH4. So how does it form? You know that carbon has 6 protons, 6 neutrons, and 6 electrons. Following the octet rule, we put the first 2 electrons in the first orbital. That's fine, but that leaves 4 electrons in the second orbital, and that makes carbon an unhappy atom. Hydrogen, as we've discussed, is also an unhappy atom because it has 1 electron rather than 2 in its outer orbital. Knowing that the chemical formula of methane is CH4, 1 carbon and 4 hydrogens, I'll bet you can figure out how to draw it. So what I'd like you to do is click pause, give it a try, and when you're ready, click play to see if you got the answer correct. Here's methane, CH4, one molecule that's making 5 atoms happy. We'll start with carbon. Because it's sharing electrons with 4 hydrogens, carbon now has 8 electrons in its outer energy level, making it happy. And because each hydrogen is sharing an electron with carbon, each hydrogen has 2 electrons in its outer orbital. A perfect match. We saw when we looked at a hydrogen molecule that hydrogen can share electrons with itself. Well, carbon can do the same thing, and that's actually critically important for the molecules of life. But knowing that carbon can do that, here's a little challenge. See if you can figure out how to draw ethane, C2H6. It's another kind of natural gas. Pause the video, give it a try, and then click play to see if you got it right. Here's ethane, C2H6. Each carbon is bonded to 3 hydrogens, and the 2 carbons are bonded to one another. Arranged like this, each hydrogen has 2 electrons orbiting its outer shell, so hydrogen's happy. Each carbon has 8 electrons orbiting its outer shell. Each carbon is happy. One molecule, 8 happy atoms. Isn't covalent bonding fantastic? So far, we've met 3 covalently bonded molecules, hydrogen H2, methane, and ethane. And now that we understand how covalently bonded molecules work, that they're held together by shared pairs of electrons, we're going to start using a different way of representing these molecules. What we'll use is called a structural formula. You'll use this type of formula throughout the rest of your studies of biology. There are 2 rules for drawing structural formulas. The first Instead of drawing out the entire atom with its nucleus and electrons and all the orbitals, you're just going to use a chemical symbol to represent that atom. Secondly, you'll represent each shared pair of electrons with a dash. So here's the structural formula for a hydrogen molecule. I've put the orbital model right next to it so you can compare the two and see how the two relate. Here's the structural formula of methane with an orbital model for comparison. If you're getting this, you should be ready for this challenge. We've already looked at the structure of ethane, C2H6. So now your job is to draw the structural formula. Pause the video, give it a try, then click play to see if you got it right. Here's ethane's structural formula. It shows how each carbon is sharing electrons with three hydrogens and how each carbon shares a pair of electrons with the other carbon. The three molecules that we've discussed so far, hydrogen, methane, and ethane, are held together by single covalent bonds. That means that the atoms inside these molecules are connected by a single shared pair of electrons, which we represent with that single dash. Sometimes the atoms in a molecule are held together by double covalent bonds. These double bonds involve two shared pairs of electrons. You can see this in the molecule ethylene, C2H4, yet another kind of natural gas. Ethylene is used as a starting point in many industrial processes, and it's used for making hundreds of different types of plastics and textiles. When you study plants, you'll meet ethylene again because it's also a plant hormone that plays a key role in the ripening of fruits. Here's an orbital model of ethylene along with its structural formula. The carbon atoms in ethylene are sharing two pairs of electrons with one another. Those two shared pairs make up a double bond, and we represent that with the double dash. At the same time, each carbon is sharing a single pair of electrons with each hydrogen, and we show that with a single dash. The result, six happy atoms, each with a complete outer orbital, and you can see the double bond between the two carbons. Oxygen, O2, the gas that we breathe in with every breath, is another double-bonded molecule. As you can see, the two oxygens share two pairs of electrons. So as a result, each oxygen now has eight electrons in its outer orbital, making it happy. We represent that double bond in the structural formula with the double dash. Even triple bonds are possible. In this compound, C2H2, acetylene, the fuel that's used in an acetylene torch, the two carbons have single bonds connecting them to the hydrogens and triple bonds connecting them to one another. That triple bond, you can see, involves three shared pairs of electrons. It's impossible to overstate the importance of covalently bonded molecules in biology. They are simply the bonds that hold the molecules of life together. You're made of covalently bonded molecules. You inhale and exhale covalently bonded molecules. You eat covalently bonded molecules. Your muscle, fat, skin, genes, they're all covalently bonded molecules. At this point in the series, you know what to do. In order to learn this stuff, you've got to interact with it, and I've set up those interactions over at my website, sciencemusicvideos.com. So go to my website. Do the flashcards, do the multiple choice quizzes, do the other activities, and that's how you're really going to come to understand how covalent bonds and structural formulas work. I also want, as always, to invite you to leave me comments, leave me questions, either on YouTube or at Science Music Videos. And if you can't think of a comment or a question, I've got one for you. It's going to appeal to the poet scientist inside of you. Here's the question. Is love more like a covalent bond, or more like an ionic bond? Leave a comment explaining what you think. I'd love to hear it, and I'll see you at the next video.